She swallowed a little bottle like this. When she was just 6 months old, some children came to her house. My wife left her to go and take her, but only for her to come back, started seeing that the girl was dragging her breath. So she tried and tried and tried to find out exactly what happened. Nobody knows. So we rushed her to the first hospital. It was when I dipped my finger inside her mouth, because saliva was coming out from her mouth. I suspected that maybe there's something, maybe she had a wound. As I dipped my hand inside her mouth, I now noticed that there's a hard object inside there. But the first hospital, they were telling us that maybe she's catching cold. I said, this can't be cold. It's very funny that a child is bringing out saliva. I say it's cold. From there, they rushed us to that hospital. She had a surgery in Port Harcourt. So after the surgery in Nigeria, so they removed she swallowed a foreign object. So after they remove her, they now placed her on a tube. So when they tried to remove the tube, to close the place there, there was no way. She couldn't tolerate it. So I was referred to another hospital in Port Harcourt. From there, they themselves could not do anything. I was sent to another hospital again in another state in Nigeria. Nothing happened. The fourth hospital, the same thing. Then we moved down to Abuja, the fifth hospital. They themselves said they don't have the equipment. We now moved to a bigger hospital again. They couldn't do anything. So my company now said, okay, since there's nothing they can do around right now, they have a better hospital in India where the case can be handled. So from there, arrangement was made to bring us down here. Believing what they said, we came down here, and immediately we arrived here. They sent the vehicle, the Fortis management sent us a vehicle from the airport. They picked us from the airport down here. The way they welcomed us, I think the reception alone, from there I started seeing green lights that something good is coming. So the morning the doctors came, I discussed with them. They assured me that there's no problem, that this one is even a very small case. I said, well, let me watch and see the magic they're going to do. They continue the work. They check everything. After trying to know some what really happened and everything, I gave them the details, everything. They said, there's no problem. I shouldn't be afraid that they have been handling the one that is more critical than this. So from there, they set it up. And right now, they have removed the tube. The girl can now eat freely, do everything freely, and she's okay. She cannot go to school. Before then, she had not been going to school because of that, because children are very, very inquisitive. They want to know what is there. Most of the time, they want to draw it. So because of that, she doesn't go to school. But right now, as we are going back, she started with her school. The hospital is fantastic. I'm pleased with all the services, from the medical team, the doctors, and the nurses. They have been very, very caring. I don't call them before they come and check her, because most times my fear is that I don't want a situation where I'll be looking for doctors and their nurses, but I don't look for them. All the time, they always come. And if I don't know, I can't take number of doctors that come and see, that always come and see her. So I think I'm satisfied with everything.